Hi there, this is David, and happy Halloween to you all! Last year I highlighted the top 10 most spookiest areas in JRPGs, but this year I think that it would be fun to look at another ubiquitous area, ghost ships. Whether for good or bad, just about every RPG worth their salt has them, and here, we're going to be ranking them based upon their spookiness. So let's go ahead and get started haunting some old JRPGs. Number 10, the Ship Graveyard of Final Fantasy V. While the first three Final Fantasy games all gave you a ship to captain, the fourth game sunk it, quite literally, while the fifth game reinstated the tradition with two ships to make up for it. The first ship that you get, Ferris's pirate ship, ends up trashed and then beached at the ship graveyard after her one true companion, Syldra, drowns. How a water dragon drowns is beyond me, but whatever. This is your first true dungeon of the game where you have to utilize all six of your job classes in order to progress. You learn about Ferris's secret, and you get some much-needed backstory on all four of your ragtag characters when you encounter the Siren at the end. Number 9, the Haunted Pirate Ship of Grandia. While this isn't Justin and Sue's first adventure, it is undoubtedly their most important one. After Justin makes his way on board the ship to New Parm, Sue stows herself away, and is, of course, caught. So they're punished with swabbing the decks, but luckily they also meet the great adventurer Fina. But she pretty much hates him at first. However, after the haunted ship approaches and stops their ship in its tracks, it's up to those three to get on board and get to the bottom of it all. It's here that Fina gains a newfound respect for Justin, and the rest is history, as they blossom from adventurers, to partners, to lovers, right in front of our eyes. Grandia's epic love story all started here, on board this pirate ship. Number 8, the Phantom Ship of Dragon Quest III. As my favorite NES game, it should come as no surprise that the game checks all my boxes. Everything good is here, and this ship was my first encounter with the trope. Thinking back on the system though, I believe that it was the only RPG on the NES that had a phantom ship, and while the ship will appear without the sailor's thigh bone in the NES version, it won't in future versions, as it wanders the game's rendition of the Mediterranean Sea. It's so sad though, because Olivia has been waiting for her lover Eric, who went down with the ship, at her promontory, so once you board, you need to find his locket and then speak to his ghost in order to reunite the two lovers at last. Number 7, the Fog Ship of Suikoden 4. The Fog Ship is very different from the other ships that we've seen on these lists, as it's not really a dungeon, but it's more of just a small little stop off for some story. The entire ship is led by a robed figure only known as the Fog Ship Guide, who has the power of one of the 27 true runes, which is the Rune of Life and Death. He then gives you a proposition to receive eternal life in exchange for your Rune of Punishment, but that's no bargain. It's only then that the robed man actually reveals himself to be Ted. Yeah, that Ted from Suikoden 1. He then ganks the rune from the Fog Ship Guide, your gang beats the shit out of him, and you rush to escape just in the nick of time as the ever-mysterious Leknot banishes him back to the Eternal City. It's not some huge long dungeon, but damn, does that scene stick with you. Number 6, the Ghost Ship of Wild Arms. This is pretty creepy. I mean, Wild Arms was nothing if not atmospheric. The ship is found wandering the seas north of the aptly named town, Ship Graveyard. Unfortunately, the ship is freaking out the lily-livered sailors, so the trio summons up their BDE, and then they go off to bust the ghosts themselves. Afterwards, the ship vanishes without a trace, and to show his gratitude, Captain Bartholomew decides to give them access to his ship, the Sweet Candy, which you can then use to sail throughout the world of Fogaia. However, in a kind of creepy turn of events, the blue chests that you couldn't get on the now vanished ship have washed up on the shore of the ship graveyard. Was it real all along or supernatural? We might never know. Number 5, the Ghost Ship of Trials of Mana. Ever hear the saying that there's no such thing as a free lunch? Well, it's true here too. If you're offered a free ride on a ship, you'd better believe that there's a catch. And in this case, the ship is haunted, and it's creepy as hell. Not only is it a ridiculous maze full of pitfalls, branching paths, and freaky deaky messages, but then, to make matters even worse, one of your party members gets cursed and then turned into a ghost. So then you just kind of have to bumble around the darkness until you finally encounter the boss, who you now have to defeat with a man down. But once you do, at least you'll get the spirit shade, only to then be dropped off on a volcanic island right before it's about to erupt. Number 4. The Incan Gold Ship in Illusion of Gaia. Can we get a remake, or at least a retranslation of this game, please? It's just so beautiful, and you can tell that the story was amazing in Japanese, but it is butchered, to say the least, in English. I honestly don't really even know what's happening in this scenario. We first enter the beautiful, luxurious vessel, speak to the passengers who are awaiting their destination, only for Will to fall asleep, and then find the ship now in a dilapidated state with everybody that you just spoke to now a pile of rotting bones. You then talk to all your friends, only to, like, wake up again, but this time you're on a raft floating God knows where. I guess it was all a dream, or maybe just an illusion of time. Number 3. The Pirate Ship Eleftheria of Ys 8. While Adol definitely has a penchant for getting shipwrecked, he normally washes up in some sort of civilization. However, in Ys 8, he's marooned on a desert isle and desperate to escape. So, the group of castaways see the ghost ship as a potential way to escape the island. Only it turns out that it was really just a way for them to escape this mortal coil. The captain was a slave-turned-pirate who roamed the seas, attacking noble ships and freeing their slaves. A noble cause indeed, but one that doomed him to a lonely death. Now, his pain and torment pilot the ship as it roams the seas around the island of Siren, and it's up to Adol to put him to rest once and for all. In doing so, though, you do get the sea chart to map the island's surrounding waters, so it's kind of a nice trade-off at least. Number 2. The Ghost Ship Aetherium of Tales of Vesperia. Normally, after you get a ship in a JRPG, the entire world opens up to you, or at least like an inner sea or something, but not here. The only thing that opens up to you is a hellish ghost ship, because immediately after setting sail, you're gonna run into the fog, and then the Aetherium, where ghosts only appear in mirrors, your party becomes split, and you get the most annoying character in the game, Patty. At least in the definitive version. It's kind of sad though. The ship has been wandering the seas for 1,000 years, just trying to fulfill the captain's mission of delivering a clear CL crystal to a town that doesn't exist anymore. Supposedly, it has the power to banish monsters, but unfortunately, it has the opposite effect on Yuri and the gang, because all it does is cause more bad luck to befall them. Number 1. The Ghost Ship of Legend of Dragoon. There's so much history attached to this one dungeon, I love it. The ship itself is actually a relic from 11,000 years ago, back whenever it was attacked by the Black Monster, and everybody on board died, including the former Moonchild, Princess Luvia. The ship continues to be haunted to this day by her nanny, who mourns her and wails that she was unable to protect the princess. As you make your way finally towards the distraught Wraith, she sees that the supposed princess is alive and well. Though, what she doesn't know is that Luvia is actually Shania's twin. The entire dungeon is just really so cool because it seamlessly ties the past and the present together to give backstory on Shania, the Moonchild, Rose, and the Black Monster. Well, that's it for the top 10 best JRPG ghost ships. I hope that you enjoyed the video and have a happy Halloween. And if you like this video or want to do here on the channel, please consider supporting me on Patreon, heading on over to Twitch for some streaming fun, or join the Discord to chat and hang out. The links to them can be found in the video description. This has been David. If you like this, please like, comment, and subscribe, and have a good day.